Very good evening, everybody, and welcome back to the Imagine Cruising 2024 World Indoor Bowls Championships. And again, we're live from Potter's Resorts here in Hopton-on-Sea. We're going back to the World Open pairs now, and it's Jason Greenslade and Michael Stepney facing the Scottish qualifiers Ronnie Duncan and Colin Walker. Well, it's time to go down to the portable rink. We're going to hand you over once again to our MC, straight out the shop window, Jack Jenkins.
Yes, thank you very much, Jason. Welcome back for this evening's match. Our first pair we have out this evening featuring a former singles semi-finalist and together former World Pairs runners-up. Please welcome out Scotland's Ronnie Duncan and Colin Walker. It's the final countdown. Their opponents are a Welsh and Scottish pairing with former Scottish Open and World Pairs Championship titles. Together, they are last year's runners-up in this event, giving up for number 9 and number 15 in the world, Jason Greenslade and Michael Stepney. Hand you up to Jason Parkinson and Emily Ferguson in the commentary box.
Thank you very much, Jack. Once again, very good evening, everybody. Welcome back to Potter's Resorts here for the Imagine Cruising World Championships. My partner in crime is back for the evening. I'd love to say my glamorous assistant, but it's Emily instead. Good evening, Em.
Thanks, Jason. What an introduction.
Thanks for joining us again. Good interview with the players before.
Thank you. Enjoyed being down ringside.
Yeah, something a bit different. Well, good game here. Jason Greenslade, Michael Stepney. Lost in the final, of course, last year.
Jack length, 27 and a half metres.
They'll be looking to go one better. Colin Walker and Ronnie Duncan. Well, they've also been to the final before, so they'll be wanting to go one better as well. So, very interesting game. Joining us for the evening. Good evening. Hope you're all okay. Happy New Year to you all. Don't forget the chat function is available for you if you want to ask any questions or need some information on what's going on or anything like that. World Bowls Tour has its own website as well, worldbowlstour.org. Schedules and draws are on there for you. Good effort, just slightly over.
One green.
Thank you.
Just over-adjusted with that one.
Yeah, he was just looking to get to the bowl, wasn't he? You know, if he did get to it and turn it, it would have been a bonus.
Just pin a yard onto it, or would you say just have a draw? Do you think I could play the forehand and off mine? Off yours, I mean.
It's the pace that's going to beat him.
One shot. Duncan and Walker.
0-1, first end.
I always find the evening game quite fascinating. For those of you that play quite regularly in the evening, no matter where you play, as the temperature drops, speed of the green changes. You see so many games where it's first set, one team does well, then it completely swaps. It's always the team that adapts first.
Jack length, 28 and a half metres.
It's quite chilly this evening here in Norfolk, Emily, isn't it?
Yeah, it's a cold one.
Ronnie Duncan's chosen to play with the famous birds, hence like Tiger, one of the older sets that we have.
Yes, Mike.
Great start from Michael.
Yeah, really nice finish that. Yeah, decent adjustment there. Gives them a decent second.
Yeah, see the way, Mike. As you, 18 down. As you see it.
Michael's just slightly overplayed that, but it's going to finish in a decent spot.
One red.
Decent effort here, if it can keep running on.
Yes, well played. Yep, the ball. Good pair.
Yeah, yard over.
Colin will follow it.
Come on, mate, just run.
Can he just get up to it? Sits off the green one. Oh, lucky.
Yeah, it was a good try, that.
You're holding two. You can't get past it. I think you're probably better just here, because if you turn it once, you probably cut one out. Just go away there. Yep. Just shove. Just lock an eye. Yeah. First in, mother.
Just not quite push that.
Two shots, Stepney and Greenslade.
It's
Set score 2-1 after two ends.
So 2-4, Michael and Jason.
Jack length, 28 metres.
Great start. See there, Michael play with the Henselite Tiger. Same as Ronnie. Question there about if you get ranking points for pairs. No is the easy answer for that one. It's only ever singles. Because players tend to play with different people year after year, so it'll be very difficult to keep track of.
Two good balls there from Michael.
Well, Ronnie needs to bend quick. Yes, well played.
Yeah, brilliant ball that. Came back really nicely.
Did, yeah, as the pace came off.
One green.
There we have Colin and Mike's family. He's just spotted himself on television. That was our famous driver of the jack and roll car in the singles game. 14 years of age, did very well despite not having a license at all. Gently.
Oh, almost turned the shot ball out of the head then. Not sure it's going to get back from that.
Just having a little more think about this one.
Obviously the danger was highlighted with his first ball there. He rocked onto the second and it did move the shot ball. Didn't cause any damage, but he doesn't want to do that again.
One shot.
Yeah, they've chosen
Duncan
to take it.
Walker.
Chickens. There's at least two
Set
inches
score.
There.
2-2 after three ends.
To see you all back on this evening to watch this game. Hope you're enjoying the championships again. Lots of good games still to come. Tomorrow we have the pairs quarterfinals plus a singles game. Canada take on Israel in that singles game.
Jack length, 28 and a half metres.
Come on, flat out. Just that yard, Ronnie. Not even.
Come on, Mike.
Just hold the run.
It's only a touch.
Not a feeling your last, Ronnie.
Better paced over the top as well. The play.
Yeah, well adjusted that. Still just not quite push this one.
Yeah, if he runs into second, which he has done, that'll help.
One green.
Nice chance for Colin here, just to add another second, put Jason under pressure.
It's not too bad, mate.
Yeah, of course.
Decent try here.
Wants to run past the jack and get to the bowl ideally. Can he come with it? Lucky.
Yeah, you're beating it in there. Jason's at 6 inches. I'm just short of jack, guy.
Yeah, Colin's just looking for the switch now. More chances to add down the backhand. Just not quite going to get back. Gives another sighter for Jason here now, though.
Yes, it does. Just thickens it up, doesn't it?
Down the ball. Just not on your last, really.
I mean, it could be a little bit wide and get just a little cheeky edge of the ball. Nice and solid. Comes back across. Let's see what the pace he plays.
I think it's off of there. Drop now. Drop.
Just struggling to get down.
That's okay. Just the ball wide. He's not turned it in for another.
One shot, Duncan and Walker.
Set score 2-3 after four ends. Jack length, 27.5 metres.
That's a decent opener, just finishing that 2 foot yard behind. As we said a couple of times during the commentary of the games, it's always better to miss behind. Gives you a skip to make work with. It can potentially be brought back into the game later on. Yeah, good start in a hit from Michael.
well. Can he just get down for this jack or the bowl? I just don't think he's quick enough for it. He's finished good though. Another one in the area.
Yeah, it's just forced Michael to switch hands as well. It's decent here as well.
We can just get right back to centre. Gets out of the way now. Yeah, gets out of sight. Another shot in, doesn't make it any bigger at all.
Two red.
Just lacking that 2 foot a yard or so.
Something very similar for Jason. Even if he gets to the jack and just turns it a little bit further away, be right in trouble then for Colin.
Yeah, absolutely. If he can just tuck it around the corner a little bit, take it out of eyesight.
Anything apart from the left-hand side of the jack, just to fatten it up.
Needs to run.
Yeah.
Well, still enough to count for a third. Colin's still looking for the draw down here. There's a bit of room.
This is going to require dead pace to get back.
That's a really good effort.
Can it sit? If it can just sit and roll around that ball for a second.
Now that last ball there is Jason's aim. If he can just sit it down, chance of getting a four. Certainly a three if he does sit it. Even the tuck around the corner will do. Well, he's drawn another if it stays up.
Yeah, I'd say it's just about to fall away.
Three shots, Greenslade and Stepney.
That's a good three. Put some in front.
Set score, 5-3 after five ends. Jack length, 25.5 metres.
You can tell Michael's from very high up in Scotland, can't you? His legs are whiter than his shirt there.
I knew exactly what you were going to say before you even finished the sentence, Jason.
They're not getting his sun that high up.
It is January.
Come on, can start.
Well, you don't need tan legs to draw well, do you?
He'll get me back for that later, I'm sure.
When he's just slightly pushing through, maybe looking to adjust that with the second. But very similar bowl here for Michael. If he can just add another one in, rest on his first one, that'll be ideal. Yeah, well played. Nice little touch as well. Yeah, I wondered if Ronnie would just change his hand here. It's a lot more inviting down the backhand. He's got a bowl to rest off. Just Just slightly pushing through again. If he'd have had a yard less pace, he would have come right back to that ball. Yeah, Jason is probably looking to cover here with his first. They're holding quite a decent two. Just looking to get back to the green bowl behind.
That's finished good there.
Don't drive it.
Really good try here.
Nice and thin.
Yeah, well played.
That's a great ball. I think that may have just got it.
Yeah, just slightly outside what he was looking for. He was looking for bowl onto Jack there. We even come down to the shot bowl.
Wasn't overly adventurous with that, was it? It was very hard to get another bit.
One shot, Duncan and Walker.
Could have just disturbed something.
Set score 5-4 after six ends.
Well, very close, one in it.
Yeah, all four players playing well at the moment.
Jack length, 28.5 metres.
Yeah, really good opener there.
It's always going to be billed as a really good game, this. I mean, all four players are very, very good quality. Colin and Ronnie struggled a little bit, to be fair, in their first game. Managed just to sneak over the line. And they've certainly gone up a few cogs here, playing like you would normally see them play.
Yeah, you've got to turn it up, really, against these two very experienced players.
Oh, Ronnie. Oh, brilliant.
Yeah, absolutely brilliant leading.
Brilliant, yeah. Practice.
It's really so important in this two bowl pairs for the lead to give your skip a good chance.
Yeah,
are the tip more or less touching? The front ball, how far short is it? How far short is the front ball? His one.
What would you be doing here, Jason?
I think I'd actually be just trying to reach, just trying to disturb something. I mean, or you try and put another ball in the head to allow Jason to play something. Obviously, if you just have one ball in the head, it's looking a bit... Either way, you try and draw one close or you try and disturb it first. I mean, he's a good attacking player, Michael. Yep. Just trying to open something up. Used to miss his own. Oh, unlucky.
Yeah, it was unlucky not to get the second one turning there as well.
It was very unlucky. Any contact on the jack would have left a load of room for both the skips. However, it was on target. Can't do much more than that.
Not quite counting, but at least it's finished behind.
Looks tight, is it?
Yeah.
It can hold sometimes. Depends how much pace he's got. Is he up? Held a long way. I thought it was just nippy.
Yeah, as soon as he let it go, but it did hold. It's actually finished quite well. Not sure he's quite pushed this one.
Yeah, just pulling up, isn't it? Just 2 feet, that's all cracking line. I think Jason's got a lot on here.
No, I think the ideal is still just that sticking to that backhand draw. He can sit onto the shot bolt.
I think the bowl is you're playing just a full draw, just guaranteeing you are arriving. If he gets round it, could maybe just get back to the shot, or if you could just lift through the front. I don't think I'll be playing anything too quick.
There's a chance as well, the way the jack's sitting, it might just spring to where his first bowl left. Yeah, right, sort of wait for it, just hanging off there.
One shot, Duncan and Walker.
Set score 5-5 after 7 ends.
Back to level. 2 ends left.
Interesting though, out of the 7 ends played, Michael Stepney and Jason Greenslade have only won 2 ends. Picked a 2 and a 3 up.
Certainly be a big advantage to win this end.
Yeah, just put their noses in front, whoever wins. Go into the end. The final end a little bit more confident.
Jack length, 28 metres.
Thank you.
Great start again from Ronnie. Definitely firing on all cylinders this evening. Two of the CD pairs are already out of this year's World Open pairs.
Super close, Mike.
Yeah, it was a really good game this morning.
Go, Michael.
Well, Mike. Oh, Mike.
Oh, brilliant leading.
Still holding. I just play it foul.
Michael there rolling his eyes. Still one down. Get within 2 inches and that's not enough. Can't even see the jack there from that camera angle. Crack and try again.
Oh my goodness, he's here again. Yeah, like I say, needs to be gently. Oh, Ronnie.
Brilliant.
Shut up.
Just see a little bit of daylight from the jack there.
Outstanding. I thought it was just going to be a little bit unlucky, but he's played that absolutely to perfection.
Yeah, if he had an inch or two more of pace, he would have just nudged the jack over to the red.
Yours is slightly short of the jack anyway.
Yeah, Michael and I are just looking to follow this up. If he can release the jack a little bit.
He's not hanging around. He's hit this as well. Well played.
Well played.
Good hit. Oh, great hit.
It's a shame that pole kept whirling with it, but still left Jason some room.
Question from Mo Bryson. Do the top 16 players play indoor and outdoor? That's a good one. Outdoors. Mark Dawes plays Crown Green outdoors. Mervyn, I don't think if Mervyn plays, Greg doesn't. We've not seen Mervyn play much outdoors at all.
No, I don't recall seeing him at Leamington.
Come on, Colin. Good run.
Just not quite get the legs there. Nice chance for Jason to lock onto this first.
Yeah, Colin will be a little bit disappointed with that, won't he? You can just see a little wry smile there.
Yeah, it's a decent sighter for him. Still leaving Colin a fair bit of room to draw in, though.
Oh, Colin. He's underneath it. Well done.
Yeah, well played. Well adjusted that. Tight. Oh, just managed to get the back side of that.
Oh, that ball's gone to the spot, look. Oh, dear.
Yeah. Two shots, Duncan and Walker.
Dreadfully unlucky. An extra little bonus shot going into the final end for Ronnie and Colin. 7-5 is the score. He was unlucky there. He was always going to still be one down, but he flicked the ball and it was just enough to follow it. Six out of eight fabulous balls there.
Yeah, it started off marvellously.
Jack both length, 29 metres.
Good start there from Ronnie.
Mm. Oh, well played. But just down to it. Yep. Well done. Well, chance here for Michael and Jason.
Yeah, ideal shot for Michael now is just to rest on that final one there. Keep it nice and tucked in. It's giving it a fair chance.
Oh, well played.
He was just going to release the jack out then, but
too
managed to keep it tucked in. As you can see there, it's quite a narrow head still.
Oh, pressure's on, isn't it? That's the, I mean, they take that that tie break. But a new jack there, I've noticed. It's got the World Bowls Tour logo on. Hit it solid and get that double bounce.
Not quite. Again, both those green bowls is just where Jason's looking. He can rest inside there. He's going to put Colin under a lot of pressure with his last bowl. Not sure he's got the pace for it though. Well, it gives Colin another chance to shut this down now.
Look at this. Isn't he looking at to destroy it? I mean,
Well, between the red and the green, I suppose, striking through.
There's a lot of funny connections.
All he's got to do is sit off the green bowl behind and he'll be getting second, if not shot. I suppose he's probably thinking Jason has got the last bowl. But that's certainly the bowl I'd be playing.
Colin.
Can you hold?
Can I just sneak by for second? It has. Oh no, my goodness. That was cruel. Very cruel. And wobbled the other way. That would have wobbled in for second.
I think if I was Jason, I'd be switching here. Look to just rest off the other green bolt on the left hand side of our screen. Doesn't want to be rocking Colin's last bowl and turning it in.
Well, they're guaranteed that half point at the moment, aren't they? That tied set, half a point each.
Exactly, so this is almost like a bonus ball for Jason now. Can he make it count and steal the set?
Comes.
Not far away, I tell you that.
It's nearly drawn this, you know. It's nearly drawn this.
Well played.
Wow.
Brilliant bowl there.
Fantastic bowl from Jason. Sneaks the first set there with
three
a triple.
Three shots and first set to Greenslade and Stepney.
It's So good evening, if you have just joined us. Welcome back to the Imagine Cruising World Indoor Bowls Championships. Great to have Imagine Cruising back with us. Lots of holidays on offer. Let's have a little sneaky peek. See there, strap line. Imagine Cruising, more than just a cruise. Certainly is. Lots on offer. Have a look at their website, www.imaginecruising.co.uk. This year we have a special code for you. It's BOWLS24. Whenever you get hold of any of their representatives, or if you look at booking a holiday, that will entitle you to a 5% discount. Lots of very, very interesting things. Still some spaces on their staycation cruise for April. Around the Canaries, Madeira, stunning, beautiful ship. Really reasonable price as well, as I'm looking at it myself. Shame I'm in Guernsey. I'd like to have tried that. So, more of the same here, please, from these players. Great first set.
Yeah, those last few ends, we really saw some absolutely cracking bowling. Couldn't have called who was going to win that one.
Two red.
Played. Jason finishing, starting this first set, how we finished the other one. The cracking draw. Decent effort here if it can fall in.
Oh, hanging on. A bit further. Hold draw, we touch the jug, we turn that ball if you're just over.
Jason just looking to follow this up. If he can rest that last ball. Yeah, brilliant ball there from Jason. Pulling the jack through.
No, mate. Get a backhand draw now. Yeah,
do. Forces Colin to switch to the backhand draw now.
Backhand draw.
You can see there's not a lot on the forehand.
Well, he's in the area of his up. Can he get up?
Oh. Great try.
One shot, Greenslade and Stepney.
One 0, first end. Jack length, 26 metres.
26 metres, somewhere bang in the middle. Jason Greenslade, ranked number 9 on the ranking list.
Yeah, well adjusted here by Michael. Still room for Ronnie though.
Two red.
Both players there just pulling up short. As Jason said earlier, these evening games, the carpet just seemed to slow down a little bit as the temperature drops outside.
I don't think it's any further than the front ones, struggling a little bit.
Colin ideally here needs to be drawing the shot with his first. He doesn't want to leave himself in trouble with his final bolt. Needs to run though. Well, he's done enough for second. I think this end might well be a case of who gets there first.
Oh, yeah, well done.
Yeah, well played, Jason.
Nice to see some of the friends on there. Rob Ferguson, hi, Jason. Hello, Robert. Yeah. Emily's fuming.
That would be my brother. He'd be playing on the portable rink in a few weekends' time in the Champion of Champions competition.
Just 18 inches.
One shot, Greenslade and Stepney.
Apart from Jason, all four players really.
Set score 2-0.
Lulled into being a yard short. Jason managed to correct with his second, but did do it with his first. You don't often see that. Something fooled them.
Chris Young, is Catherine playing this year? I'm sure you're talking about Catherine Rednall. Yep, Pocket Rocket's back. She'll be playing the mixed pairs and also the ladies' match play.
Jack length, 25 and a half metres.
She plays Nicole Rogers in the ladies' match play, one of the England qualifiers. That's going to be a tough game for Catherine because Nicole is an extremely talented player, very natural player. Sorry, that's my correction. Look at the mixed pairs there. She plays against Nicole in the mixed pairs because she's playing with Les. That's a good pair, isn't it? Les Gillett, Catherine Rednall against Wayne Wilgrass and Nicole Rogers. Oof.
Yeah, that'll certainly be one to watch.
Locals against each other as well, so that could get interesting.
Hope I'm commentating on that one.
Yes, of course. She plays Annalisa, doesn't she, in the match play? The other English qualifier. I got it half right.
Yeah, they play on Sunday. Yeah, two good bowls there for Michael.
Oh, yeah, there, brother. Get into that wee split jacket. There, pal. Come on.
I don't like you.
Run.
Well, run, you can just hurry into the split, any of the splits. Oh, good bowls. Four excellent bowls once again. Spectacular bowls, this one.
One green.
Yeah, I really can't call who's going to be winning this match. All four players playing well.
Interesting comment there. Bowls needs a Luke Littler. I mean, I watched the darts. I thought it was excellent. The qualifier from Hong Kong this year in the singles, he is 15 years of age. Qualified at 14. He's had a birthday since. So 15 years of age. He's the youngest ever qualifier for the World Open Singles, I think, in the main event. So, I mean, if he has a really, really good run, he could well be the next Nuke Luke.
Well, see what he does this time. Look a bad line when you let off. Get down. Red one.
Oh, over it goes.
Oh, it's just going to fall back. Obviously, he was looking to turn that bowl onto the jack to make two of it, but it just rocked and fell back. Really unlucky.
Yeah, if it just flipped over.
You can only really get to that sort of area. Just in case the jack goes too far.
Well played bowl, the bat bowl, because it forces Jason to play exactly that dead neat pace. It's very, very difficult. You know, if he plays anything more than probably 2 feet, probably be too much. So just up to it again, just flip it up or flip it over. Flop it out that way and it'll just go onto the jack, hopefully.
Just like that.
Maybe some more weight, I think it's just holding.
Yeah, it's a bit quick.
Just heavy enough. That was all. Just heavier, that was all.
Just having a little look at this, there is a chance on the backhand.
Yeah, just made sure I was up.
Yeah.
I'm not.
It's a bit of danger, but he could lift his green bowl onto the jack and potentially made a couple of it, but equally it is fraught with danger too. Even if he's springing it a yard through, they have got the best positions. I think that's what I'd be playing. Just looking to come up on the backhand. Can afford to pay 2 feet a yard or so.
On shot, Duncan and Walker.
Set score 2-1 after three ends. Jack length, 28 metres.
Good opening bowl here from Ronnie.
Having a good game, isn't he?
He's really settled on the pace, been very consistent.
Again, just get in between, it'll be great.
Yeah, brilliant bowling.
Winner of this game faces Jason Banks and Paul Foster, 2 o'clock tomorrow afternoon. Head needs to get one in quickly. Can use that bowl. Good evening, Tinas. Hope you're okay in South Africa. Well, this is having a good look. Doesn't want the hole.
Oh, he's just going to get the gap. Really unlucky there.
They've had a few little bits of. Bit of bad luck, haven't they? Like a little wrong touch or a few gaps as well. It's obviously hit the target a few times. I mean, playing some good stuff. Quite happy with the three, just looking for a little bit of cover. I mean, there's that three ball plant that I think he's going to be playing. Didn't want to try and be greedy and make a fourth, but fatten the head up a little bit. So it's a good bowl that I think we'll see Jason run straight through this.
Yeah, haven't been so unfortunate with his first. Forces him to play that almost.
Jason, how's your look this time? Oh my goodness. Dear me.
Two shots, Duncan and Walker.
Again, almost on target, just didn't get that result.
Four ends.
So Ronnie and Colin just sneak in front. Set they need to win, obviously, to take it to a tie break.
Duck length, 28.5 metres.
Yeah, another really good opener here from Ronnie. Gonna certainly be pleased with how he's played today.
Beat it.
He has as well. Yeah, these two are having a really good tussle at the front.
They certainly are.
Down you go, mate. Get a wee effort here. Let's settle. Good effort.
Just up.
How's it play, Mike? Yeah. Turn yours down.
You'll be just drawing this ball as if that green ball isn't there. If you start looking at it, that's when you start messing around with your line. Just take out your memory. If it goes over the top, will be best now.
That's unlucky there. If he'd have just slipped that, he'd have been finishing in one a very red. Good spot.
Michelle McKinnon, how did the players achieve a top 16 ranking? The WBT are obviously World Bowls Tour ranking events. Each round is worth so many points. So if you win your first game and you go into the second round, you get 10 points for winning the first game here. So at the World Championships, it's 10 ranking points per round. Scotland, slightly different. Scottish International Open, total of 40 ranking points for that one. And then you achieve them. It's every 3 years. The score from the 3 years before drops off. That's how it works. The ranking list is on the World Bowls Tour website. You can have a little look. And there's also an explanation there of how those ranking points are accumulated.
An effort here. Drop now. Really good try here.
Get past. Oh, brilliant.
It's done well not to fallen over, actually. Yeah. It's left a gap. So it's shaping up to be quite a wide head. Might look quite inviting just to play through this now. Danger is obviously they haven't got bowls to the right hand side of the head, and that is where the jack will be going. Not sure whether they'll win the re-spot. They have got woods behind, but the way that bowl's sitting, the jack's going to squeeze out to the left hand side of our screen rather than go all the way back.
On the outside, yeah, just wide.
Well, can you do that again then, Jason?
I was gonna say, it's going to be gently. Could just draw to the back of it, couldn't he? Trouble is, you can see, look at all those green bowls there.
up for you. He's new. Just.
Doesn't want to lift it over. That's okay.
Two shots. Greenslade and Stepney.
So he didn't really want to be too quick,
first
because
score,
if he landed on the back of it, that
end.
Jack would have flung down the bat there, and it looked very looked very ominous. Talk about Alex Marshall, I see on the chat there in the open singles draw. Yeah, you're right, he's just slightly out of the top 16. However, World Championships sponsor gets two sponsors' choices. This year it's Alex Marshall MBE. And Harry Goodman.
Jack Langs, 26 metres.
So asking it to run.
Yeah, one of Michael's more looser ends. Big chance for Ronnie to step in now. Add another one in.
Sit.
Mm. Yeah, well played. All on weight now. It's looking pretty steady. If you can get the inside of the bowl. Yeah, well played.
Yeah, he is. Very well played.
Well, he wasn't far away with his first, Jason.
No, he wasn't, was he?
If he can just follow that up and rest on his own, he'd be in with a very good chance of getting the shot. Slow down and rest on the bowl.
Has done.
Full. Yeah, well played.
Big bowl that.
really fallen quite tucked away as well.
Now, I'm just wondering whether he'll risk flicking the ball away straight through the hole.
Either that or just following Jason up.
Yep, that's the other option. I think he was looking to try and get to the bowl or turn the jack into the pack.
Set score 5-3 after six ends. Jack length 25 meters.
Keep talking about the spots there. So they lay the tee down 3 meters from the ditch, and each of the spots are a meter apart as they go up the rink, apart from the very last spot, which is just ever so slightly under half a meter, which is why the full length becomes technically, we call it 29.5 meters, but it's a very, very fraction.
Every inch. Okay, Mike.
Then you have the two respots, of course, either side of the tee, equidistance between the outer rink marker and the tee, and then it's 300 millimetres back towards the ditch. Again, two good opening bowls.
This end will be quite crucial for Ronnie Duncan and Colin Walker to score here. End seven, pretty important one to win, especially as they're a set down. That finishes quite nicely.
One green.
Of course, that little extra spot at the front that isn't quite half a metre, that's there purely because if you're playing in the other direction and the tee's on the, sorry, the mat's on the tee, that indicates where the minimum 23 metre length jack is. So then the officials, as the jack's travelling down the green, that's how they quickly work out in the head the jack length for the players. All very technical.
Too technical for me.
I've had a good teacher.
Played, it's just run through though.
Yeah, meaning about 18 inches in there. Couple of balls right there. All in the weight.
Not quite got the legs.
No, perfect line, wasn't it?
Well, a big chance for Colin now to add another one in.
If you do get the jack, it's a bonus. Try and draw.
Yeah, these kind of shots, you just concentrate on the draw. Draw into the jack. If you get the jack, it's a bonus. If you go chasing it, you tend to play the wrong line.
Yeah, really good effort here.
Oh, well played. Can he get the touch? Oof.
Not quite, but
two shots,
too good.
Duncan and Walker.
Set score 5-5 after seven ends.
Well, another very interesting end to another set. Which way is it going to go? I have no idea at all. It could go anyway. All four players playing some really good stuff.
Jack length, 29 metres.
Well, we've certainly not had many ends that have started like this. Well adjusted though from Ronnie.
Yeah, it certainly is.
Still a fair bit of room for Michael to step in though.
Again, they're both looking for that little bit of an advantage going into this, into the last end by winning this one. I mean, Michael and Jason, they've got that added luxury of already having that first set under the belt. Just not going to make it.
One green.
Oh, good opening bowl there. Just pulled up a little bit short again, though.
Yeah, I think it's just enough to be in for a second. And Jason, the option, either draw or you play quick and remove the bowls. He's never afraid to attack Jason.
Got something moving.
What's the result this time? Oh.
Yep.
I was going to be a little bit unlucky there. Jack probably travelled a little bit further than ideally wanted, but it's enough. Two down to one up. Big bowl for Colin. Played it very, very well.
Yeah, well played. Yeah, Jason just looking to go again here. If he can get the bowl turning, half of the jack to the left-hand side.
Yeah, if he flicks that jack to the far left, wow, that would be a result. Forehand with pace.
Nice.
And onto the jack. Oh, well played, sir. Played that pace where he stayed in for another. That is a big difference. Huge difference.
Absolutely. Ronnie and Colin were lying two at one point.
Well, it's left them with them needing a three on this final end. Quick question there about the dress code. Yes, obviously you get given the shirts. You give your green bowls, you play with the green and white shirts, okay. Vice versa. You can either then play with either shorts or trousers, and you're allowed to wear either black or white. Both team members must play in the same coloured shorts or trousers. And flat-soled shoes, obviously. Ooh.
Three shots, Stepney and Greenslade.
Dearie me, that was just in for a third. That is a huge result.
So
and a massive
eight,
bowl
five,
from Jason Greenslade there.
Eight ends.
They need a full house here now.
Jack length, 26 metres.
Excellent start there.
Well, all you do when you're protecting the four is you just pat the head out, Emily, don't you? Pat the head out, look for any possible groupings of bowls, just keep matching away.
Yeah, just shutting down any hope for the opposition.
I mean, again, good start.
That's fine there.
And again, try and beat your own.
Still very much in the game of it being behind.
Yeah, that's all you can do, isn't it? Just keep putting them in. Just try and create something. Oh, the opposition have a little bit of a loose end.
Jason can trail the jack anywhere here. He's really shutting down any chance for Ronnie and Colin to pick up a four.
It's very close. Draw that. Full draw in there.
I think he just needs to draw, just in case there is that little bad result of getting just down to the red ball through the hole, giving them a lot more room for a four. Just close it down, just draw to the two balls just slightly past the jack.
Hurry all you've got now. Hurry the last bit. Yep.
Up yet. Yep, something like that's perfect. Yep.
Try and cut the last ball away. I think the green one could be beating Mike's.
Well, not an easy ball to play.
Yeah, well,
made the four almost impossible now.
As long as you're beating that one, really.
Yeah, Jason doesn't need to get anywhere near this. Just matches the last ball. Well, how do you make a four out of this one, Jason?
You cheat.
Well, that's not allowed, so...
Okay, then you don't. Hit and hope.
He's got his own. He's not even got his own.
Another single shot for Michael and Jason Greenslade, and they're going to win the second set. Nine shots to five.
Shot and second set to Jason Greenslade.
Fantastic game from both of the teams there. I hope you really enjoyed that, but it's going to be the pairing of Jason and Michael that will go through to tomorrow's quarterfinal. So, once again, thanks for joining us down here. We're going to have a quick look at our sponsors and some of the amazing trips that they have to offer.
To do anything like that.
You know, the old days of the boring holiday are over, I'm afraid, ladies and gentlemen.
Start discovering the world, and don't forget that all-important code BOWLS24 for your 5% discount. Well, let's look at the first few games that are coming up for you tomorrow. We have got at 9:30, we've got Nick Brett and Greg Harden. They're taking on Mark Dawes and Jamie Chesney. Straight away after that one, round about 11:15, is Mark McPeak and Stuart Bennett. They're taking on Stuart Anderson and Darren Bennett. And then obviously at 2 o'clock, with the winner of that game, it's going to be Michael Stepney and Jason Greenslade taking on Paul Foster and Jason Banks. Later on in the afternoon, then we're going to cut back to the singles around about a quarter to four. It's Israel's Sasson Eliahu will take on Dylan Jacobs of Canada. And then in the evening, it's Robert Paxton and Jamie Walker taking on Paul Wallace and Kenny Johnstone. Well, I'm afraid that is all we have time for this evening. So from everybody here at the Imagine Cruising World Indoor Bowls Championships, it's a very goodbye now. Bye-bye.